Hey guys, today we are going to discuss about the Poiseuille's equation. Poiseuille's equation is related to Q. Q means flow of the blood, which is directly proportional to the pressure gradient, but it is inversely proportional to resistance. Mean that when the resistance decreases, the flow of the blood will be increases. And when the resistance will be increases, the flow of the blood will be decreases. And if I show here a diagram, this one is a simple diagram without any thrombi, and the normal flow of the blood is a laminar flow. What's the mean of the laminar flow? The mean of the laminar flow that in the blood vessel, the blood flow in a regular or the smooth shape. In the parallel shape, so that the value of the blood will be increases. But for example, if there is a formation of any thrombi, then due to the thrombi, there is increase the value of the resistance. But when the resistance is increases, then this all flow of the blood will be disturbed. Then the flow of the blood will be decreases. Mean that in the normal flow, when there is not any type of the thrombi, then the blood can easily pass in a regular or the smooth shape. But when there is a formation of the thrombi due to the high resistance, then it's caused to production of the high resistance, then it caused to decrease the flow of the blood, because that it disturbed the laminar flow. So it was about resistance. And if I show here, when there is a low value of the resistance, and how the flow of the blood is increases. For example, there is low resistance, but the flow of the blood will be increases. When the flow of the blood will be increases, it is also very difficult for the tissue to capture its nutrients. Because that the flow of the blood speed will be increases. So that due to the decrease of the resistance, when the speed of the blood will be increases, so it is very difficult for the tissue to capture its nutrients. So if now I have described about the that how resistance affect on the flow of the blood, and if I come here on the resistance, and the resistance is directly proportional to viscosity. This one is a symbol of viscosity. If we double the viscosity, then resistance will also double. And if we double the length, then also double the resistance. But resistance is inversely proportional to radius. We will discuss about resistance and viscosity. Viscosity depend upon the hematocrit value. And hematocrit is that how much percentage of the red blood cells are present in the blood. The normal value of the hematocrit or the red blood cells is 40 to 45%. But when the value of the hematocrit will be increased, then the value of the resistance will be increased. Why the value of the resistance will be increased? Because that viscosity is directly proportional to resistance, and viscosity is also directly proportional to number of red blood cells present in the blood, which is also known as a hematocrit. And the normal value of the hematocrit is a 40 to 45%. When the value of the hematocrit or the red blood cell will be increases in the blood more than the 40 to 55%, mean that when a high value of the red blood cell will be production occurred due to any problem, for example, there is a problem of the multiple myeloma, there is a tumor in the bone marrow, when there is a present of the, it is just, I'm giving an example that if there is a tumor in the bone marrow, then bone marrow cells increase the production of the red blood cells. When it increase the production of the red blood cells, then it increase the value of the hematocrit. When it increase the value of the hematocrit, then it increase the value of the viscosity. When it increase the value of the viscosity, then it increase the value of the resistance. So in this way, that when the value of the red blood cell will be high, then hematocrit will be high. When hematocrit will be high, then the viscosity will be high. When viscosity will be high, then the resistance will be high. Resistance will be high, and when the resistance will be high, we again come at that point that resistance is inversely proportional to the flow of the blood. And when the resistance will be high, then the flow of the blood will be decreases. When the resistance will be increases, the flow of the blood will be decreases. So in this way, the viscosity affects on the flow of the blood. And when the high value of the viscosity means that there is a simple blood vessel. There is a simple blood vessel, but due to the viscosity, the flow of the blood will be decreases. Mean that it's very slowly. So it is very difficult for the tissue to capture its own nutrients. Mean that it is very difficult for a tissue to capture its own oxygen. When it is very difficult for the oxygen capturation process, then it's caused to the hypoxia. At the end, it can also lead to cell death. So this was the about the viscosity and how the low value of the viscosity affect on the flow of the blood. For example, in hemorrhage is the flow of the blood outside from the blood vessel. For example, this one is a blood vessel, and due to any external damage, the flow of the blood will be disturbed and it comes outside. The flow of the blood will be disturbed and it comes to the outside. And the value of the viscosity mean that it causes to decrease the number of the red blood cells. When it causes to decrease the number of the red blood cells, then it causes to decrease the value of the hematocrit. When it causes to decrease the value of the hematocrit, then it causes to decrease the value of the viscosity. And in this way, we know viscosity is directly proportional to the resistance, mean that the value of the resistance will also decrease, and the flow of the blood will be increases. When the flow of the blood will be increases, what's the effect of the flow of the blood on the blood vessel? For example, the flow of the blood increases, its effect and disturb the laminar flow, and it's come into the shape of the turbulent flow. Turbulent flow, it is irregular flow. This one is normal flow, but due to the decrease of the resistance, the number of the flow of the blood will be increases. When the flow of the blood will be increases, or the speed of the blood will be increases, then it causes to form of the turbulent flow. Turbulent flow is a irregular flow. When it causes to the turbulent flow, then fluid within the blood vessels affect and attack on the blood vessel. Mean that this turbulent flow will affect on the blood vessel. This will affect on the blood vessel, and this produce a current which is known as a pericrant. So when there is a high speed of the flow of the blood, then its effect on the blood vessel, and it also can damage the blood vessel. When it can damage the blood vessel, then it also can cause the hemorrhage. So this was how the viscosity affect on the flow of the blood. And resistance is inversely related to radius. Draw here a circle. In the inner circle, this one is the center. From center to circumflex, this is known as a radius. And the equation of the radius is equal to C 2 pi r. Mean that C 2 pi r. This one is the equation. In this, we can see that C is a diameter. C is a total diameter. And half of the diameter is equal to the radius. Half of the diameter is equal to the radius, and this center is the half of the diameter. So it shows that if the resistance increases, then it causes to 16 times decreases of the radius. For example, when resistance increases, the radius decreases 16 times. And when the radius increases one time, then it causes to increase the resistance 16 times. 16 times resistance increases if radius increases one time. This one is inversely proportional. How is that? That this one is a radius. For example, this one is a 2.5 centimeter. I'm just giving an example. If we increase the radius size from this one is normal, but if we increase the size of the radius, then it affect on the resistance. Then the flow of the blood can easily pass. And it causes to decrease of the resistance. And if we show that this one is the first equation of the Q means the flow of the blood, delta P is the pressure gradient, R is the resistance, and R, if we put the value of the R in this equation, then we can get a equation like that. Q delta P, we put the value of the R in this, then we can get a equation like that. Delta 8 is cos t R pi R 4. This will go upward and the equation will be like that. Delta P pi R and 8 P. This one is a proper equation. Mean that the flow of the blood is directly proportional to the pressure gradient. How much the flow will be increases, it causes to increases of the pressure. How much the flow of the blood will be increases, the radius will also be increases. And it is inversely proportional to the viscosity and the length. And how much the viscosity will be decreases, then the flow of the blood will be increased. So that was all about the problem.